Sup guys, Football Galaxy here, and all of the new 2018 MLS kits have now launched. So now, thus, I have made the video that I promised you guys I would do. So without further ado, it's time for the top MLS 2018 kits. The video in which I will be reviewing and picking my top MLS kits. So let's get this countdown started. On rank number 24, the reason why I'm ranking 24 is because I'm including the two LAFC kits, by the way, making a total of 24 MLS kits for 2018. So for rank number 24, it's Sporting Kansas City. Now, the reason why is because I really do not like the idea of black. They've always been blue, a baby blue apparently, and then a dark blue. Now, that's Sporting Kansas City, not this imitation of Vancouver Whitecaps. So I don't like it at all, which is why I put it as number 24. I know there's some who might disagree. I'm sorry, but that is my opinion. I really do not like it. At all, pretty much. At all. So let's move on. On number 23, we got Montreal Impact. Sorry for the bad photo. Just, that's like the best. The only photo I could find that had a good shot was like this. So, for some weird reason, so I'm sorry for the bad angle. But still. This is number 23 for me because, for one main reason. For me, it looks the exact same thing. The only difference is that they put that 25 logo with the IMFC. I mean, seriously, isn't it literally the exact same jersey with just that logo? So it's like no difference. It's like saying you buy this car for 1 year. Next year, you go up to your friend and say, "Look, I got a new car," but it's the exact same thing, exact same mark, exact same color. But you only put like a stamp on it. And that's it, done. So yeah, it's like, in other words, this jersey's like not really a big deal. So yeah, that's number 23, Montreal Impact. In number 22, we got Real Salt Lake. Now, this is like a much better jersey, to be honest with you. But the thing is that it kind of looks a lot similar to the one from last year. The only difference is that now it has blue sleeves, which makes it look pretty good. Which is why I didn't put it as my least favorite. I actually like it. But it's not as awesome as the rest jerseys. And it's not that much of a big, huge deal because, like I said earlier, it kind of looks similar to the rest jerseys in the past. It's still a good jersey, but it's like we're looking like in a retro look. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. Ranked number 21, we got San Jose Earthquakes. Now, I have to admit, this jersey is probably one of the best away kits I've seen of San Jose. I kind of do not like the white, though. It just looks off. It just doesn't look as usual as for San Jose. But I have to admit, it totally beats the one from last year. The one with the red strip. Oh, I hated that. It, like, reminded me almost of New England Revolution. So that looked horrible. Now, I really like how it's white and blue. So it stands out and it looks really much, really good. It is a lot better than the one from last year. So, which is why, for San Jose, it is on rank number 21. Next, we have Houston Dynamo. Now, Houston made probably one of the most unique and interesting designs of any MLS kit this year. I really like how it's black because black is one of the colors of Houston Dynamo. And I really love the orange strip showing the different shades of orange. It looks really good, really classy. It totally represents Houston Dynamo, which is why I ranked this as number 20. Now, the reason why it's number 20 is because there's other jerseys that are a little bit much better. But other than that, this jersey looks really good. And I really do like it. It looks good for Houston. But there are more that I prefer more. Number 19, we have New England Revolution. Now, for this jersey, I would say this is more like a good away kit for New England. But it actually looks pretty good. I like the two strips on the right side, the darker and then the light blue shade. It looks good. I kind of prefer, though, the one from last year. But this one looks pretty good. Not that bad. And, it's a good look for New England. I really do like it. It was one of the first kits that came out this year. And it looks pretty good. It totally represents New England. So this is a pretty good jersey, which is why it is ranked number 19. And next, we have the Seattle Sounders. Now, if I haven't mentioned before, Seattle Sounders is not one of my favorite clubs in MLS. But they are good at making good jerseys. This one being their new primary jersey, and it looks pretty good. I like their new design. It has like a nature taste to it because like the green, how it has like those different types of patches and shades. So it looks pretty good, and I actually like that blue, that like the bright blue strips that it has on its shoulders. So it's not that bad. It's a good jersey, but it just doesn't have the feeling of being in the top spotlight, you know? Which is why it is ranked number 18 in this countdown. Next, we have Colorado Rapids with their sort of old-looking, exact-looking jersey from last year. The only literal difference is that they added a baby blue, well, strips to it. It doesn't look that bad. It looks okay. To be honest with you, it actually matches the logo, which is why it makes it look good. This is an actual good-looking jersey for Colorado Rapids. They did an excellent job in doing it. The last one from last year looks pretty good, but this one looks great because it matches the colors, the exact same colors as from their logo, which is why it holds rank number 17 in the MLS countdown. A great job by Colorado Rapids. Next, I have LAFC. Now, for those who know that I am a major anti-LAFC guy, you might be thinking, well, why the heck do you not have them like in last place if you hate them so much? Because their jerseys are okay. Like a meh. Well, actually, I'm dividing them by the primary and the away kit. This one comes first, because I didn't like it that much. In fact, I even asked for some of my friends, and they didn't even like it at all. Which is why it should go more in the back. But to show mercy to them, I put them as rank number 16. It looks okay. It's good. I actually do like the blue, the black, and the gold. It looks really good. It's a really unique design. I do not like the YouTube TV logo. It's the most stupidest thing on the whole jersey. Now, I know there might be some of you LAFC fans that are going crazy by now, but hey, I warned you in a couple videos that I hate LAFC. Okay? I'm sorry. I just do. I'm just putting out my opinions about your unique, unique new primary jersey. It looks okay. The YouTube TV is the only thing that's stupid. I even asked them, some of my friends, and they agreed. It's like one of the most idiotic sponsors to sign up with. It looks so dumb. If they would at least put the YouTube TV to gold, then the jersey would look a little better. But it's not. Well, it sucks. Now, before I lose my mind of going crazy about how much I hate LAFC, I was going to continue on. FC Dallas, and it looks really, really good. It has like a total classic retro look, like something that we've seen back in the 80s or the 90s. So it looks really good. I really do like it, which is why I put it, more better than LAFC. Because LAFC looks like they put in the La Brea Tar Pits, and boom, there we go, done. They just put posters, pasted some gold strips in the YouTube Stupid TV, and that was it. But for this one, it looks like they did put effort to it. It actually looks like the USA, like a USA jersey, which is why it looks good. So my compliments to the design, to the designer of this jersey for FC Dallas. Next, we have LAFC's away kit, which you already know by my opinion about the black primary kit. It's okay, just the UTTV is stupid and idiotic. For this one, it looks like a baseball jersey, to be honest. Other than that, it actually looks pretty better. I asked some of my friends, and they agreed the white jersey looks a little bit better, if not even a lot better than the black jersey. The black jersey looks pretty bad. Like, it's not good, let's just put it that way. This one looks a little bit better. The YouTube TV is still stupid because it stands out. Other than that, I like how it's white and the gold strips on the shoulders. So besides that, it's okay, and it is a lot better than the black jersey. On rank 13, we have DC United with a new, total classic-looking jersey. It looks really good. I actually do like it. I like the horizontal strips on it. Actually, I like the black strips on the shoulders. It looks classic and retro. It looks pretty good. In fact, if I say, pretty much most of the new this year's MLS kits have like a retro look, which is why it makes them look really good. As for DC, it looks pretty good. I like the four stars they have in the logo, showing their four MLS Cup winners. So it looks pretty good by DC United. Next, we have New York City FC with an all-new gray and slick-looking blue slash jersey. It looks, like I said, it looks really slick. It looks pretty cool. This is probably one of my favorite jerseys. And a great away kit by New York City FC. It's like a totally complete design. It looks unique. Looks pretty darn good, like I said earlier, for the third time now. I really do like it. It's a good jersey by New York City, representing their city in New York, considering apparently how New York Red Bulls do not represent New York City FC. I do not know what that is all about, but that's not a matter because I don't care about those two teams. But I do care about this jersey because it looks pretty darn good. Next, we have Atlanta United's all-new King Peach jersey. Now, here's my opinion. Last year's away kit looked pretty darn good because of the red strips. This peach color, similar looking to orange from this angle, just doesn't seem right. Like, what the heck were they thinking? I know it's like a valuable thing for the fans, but for a guy who's not a whole fanatic to Atlanta United, it just doesn't look right. It doesn't look that good. It's okay. I like the kind of white patches that it has on the white background, but it looks like Houston Dynamo, to be exact. It's like a good jersey for Houston Dynamo, but not exactly for Atlanta United. I mean, it's okay. Don't get me wrong. I like it. It just doesn't seem like if it would be Atlanta United. It's a good jersey, though. Which is why I must congratulate them for making the all-new King Peach kit. Next, we have Minnesota United. I guess many people did not like the primary jersey from last year because of their dumb old-looking blue slash, which looked horrible. Now they made a complete new design with vertical slashes across, which makes it look really good. It's a lot better looking. I like the new design. I like the white with the Adidas and the Target with the logo on the right side. I don't really get that red button though, like right at the center. I just don't get that. But other than that, it looks okay. It actually looks better than Atlanta United's away kit. I'm sorry about that, folks. But this is my opinion, like I said earlier in the beginning. It looks pretty good. I like the blue strips on its side, so it's a really good and new jersey for Minnesota United. Next, we have Vancouver Whitecaps with an all-new black and white jersey. I'm telling you, I think Sporting Kansas City copied this look. It looks horrible for Sporting, but it does look good for Vancouver. Reason why is because of the name itself, Whitecaps. So that white that it has on the strips, on the shoulder, and on the tip of the sleeves, it looks really good, especially with the new, with the look of the logo, the Adidas, and the bell. So it looks really good. It looks classic. It looks a great away kit for Vancouver Whitecaps. Rank number 8, we have Toronto FC with its all new white kit. Now, here's my opinion. It looks actually really good. I like the red strips it has on the side, and I like that dark gray strip that it has on the tip of its sleeves. It looks really good with the all new star that it has for its first MLS Cup from last year. And to be honest with you, I actually do like this better than the one from last year. I kind of do not like that blue strip that it had horizontally in front from last year because it just didn't fit well. This one looks great because it's red and white. So a great away kit for Toronto FC. In rank number 7, we have New York Red Bulls with his all-new red jersey. Now, many people were absolutely happy with this jersey, in my opinion. No doubt, probably the best away jersey for New York Red Bulls. People were begging for them to make a red jersey, and boom, their prayers were answered by the wings of the Red Bulls from New York. Boom. It looks magnificent. It looks stupendous. It looks great. It is a great jersey for New York Red Bulls and probably one of their best jerseys ever. And for me, it is probably one of the best jerseys for this year for MLS. So it's a great jersey. I really do like it. And it has a similar design to the slashes in the background as for Real Madrid, which makes it look unique. So on top of that, it's a great jersey, a great new look for this year for New York Red Bulls, and I'm pretty sure the fans are going crazy over this all-new red jersey. It looks stupendous. It just looks really good and excellent. Great job on the designer who designed this for New York Red Bulls. And next, we have the Chicago Fire with their all new primary kit. It looks really good, to be honest with you. I really like the blue strips that it has on the shoulder and the white strips that it has in the center and on the tip of the sleeves. It looks really good. A great look for the Chicago Fire. It really does represent them. Like, you see it, and boom, hey, look at that. It's the Chicago Fire. So it's a really great jersey, which is why it holds as number 6 in this MLS countdown. We are officially on the top 5 jerseys of MLS 2018, ladies and gentlemen. For rank number 5, we have Columbus Crew with their all-new black 2018 kit. And I have to say, it looks really good. I like the black strips that it has on its side. And the yellow logos for the MLS, Adidas, and their Columbus Crew. It looks really good. Probably one of their best. I don't know about their best. But it is a really good away kit for Columbus Crew. I just cannot wait to see them play with that jersey on the field. And number 4, we have Philadelphia Union with their all-new, really cool-looking primary jersey. I really love the horizontal strips of the blue and then navy blue. And then I love the gold strips that I have on the shoulder and on the tip of the sleeves. It looks really good. I think I do prefer this one than the primary jersey from last year. It looks really good. I really love it, which is why I hold it's number 4 in this MLS ranking. It looks really good. I really do like it. It's a great look for Philadelphia Union. We are now in the top 3. Orlando City Soccer Club with their all-new away kit with the white and the purple. Now, I have to say, it looks really, really, really good. Which is why it holds number 3. Now, the one from last year, looked good with the gold strips they had. But this one looks really classy looking, you know? Like sleek, like cool looking. Great look for Orlando with the all white. And then I love the purple strips that it has on the shoulders and on the tip of its sleeves. So it's a really good look for Orlando. I really do like it. Let's see how they will do as they play with their own new jersey for 2018, the away kit. Number 2, we have Portland Timbers with their all new awesome, awesome, awesome looking retro white jersey. I have to say, it beats the crap from last year by 100. The stupid red and black horizontal strips were horrible. Like, what were they thinking? How do those colors represent Portland Timbers? Now with this awesome looking white with green and gold, it looks stupendous. It's like they finally opened their eyes and boom, the prayers were answered, and that is amazing. It is a great looking jersey for Portland Timbers. Probably the best away kits I've ever seen by Portland Timbers. Which is why this jersey does make for me my second favorite MLS jersey for this year. It is a great look, a great jersey, and I cannot wait to see Diego Valeri play in this all new 2018 classic retro look for Portland Timbers. And number 1, for those who have not guessed already, it would be for me the all-new 2018 primary kit for LA Galaxy. This is no doubt my favorite jersey for MLS. And come on, guys. You guys already know I'm a major Galaxy fan. So, of course, I would choose my favorite team. But not only that, it looks really, really good. I love the slash. And there are some people that I know that hate the slash for some reason. I enjoy it. I like it. And this one looks really good. I thought they were screwed it up, but they made a great job designing the new slash with the two gold strips surrounding the dark navy blue strip. Or slash, whatever you like to call it. Anyway, it looks really good. It's a great new look for 2018 for LA Galaxy. A great new primary jersey for them. And as you can see, they changed the MLS logo back to the old one from like 2015, you know, like 2016, 2015. No, not 2016, like back in 2015, to like that gold, to the bottom part of that MLS logo, they made it back to gold. It looks pretty good. I really do like it. And this jersey looks awesome with the blue navy strips on the shoulder and with the all new classic blue and gold slash. So folks, that is pretty much it. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for watching my top MLS 2018 kits. Post in the comments what your opinions are. Please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for the next upcoming event on the Football Galaxy channel. The MLS 18 show.
It's a series of which I will be reviewing each week in MLS. So stay tuned for the first episode of the MLS 18 show of week one, of which I'll be reviewing, obviously, the first week of Major League Soccer. So folks, again, thank you for watching this video, thank you for watching my channel, and stay tuned for that next upcoming series. And until then, have yourselves a good Galaxy night.